What's up? Listen up. Here we go. Ori and the House is one hell of a show. Don't you know? A critically acclaimed masterpiece, so they said. And with Ori wrested from the spirit tree by the Great Storm, now thriving under the motherhood of Naru, I'd like to test that theory. And I'm sure you're making judgments with your eyes already. The visual style is remarkably Miyazaki. It looks wonderful, and it's impressive coming from a team that originally didn't know how to draw. 4 years later, every frame a painting. You see this tree in the background, and this mushroom or this rock. That's the one and only place you'll ever see those assets. There's no tiling whatsoever. In this video, we're going to find out why Ori feels so good. Started with a jump. There's a reason that Ori was given spring-jointed legs. Something that almost everyone can agree on is that Ori feels great, but in matter of control, critics generally have no vocabulary beyond responsive and clunky. The secrets of what is literally termed game feel are reserved for the industry magicians. Despite this, I'm gonna try to explain why. As Ori jumps, notice the way she contracts and expands to reflect impact and levity. The hyperbolic squash and stretch make her behave almost like a spring. You'll be connected to it. Being able to adjust height according to the length of a jump input is nothing new for platformers, but it's repeated for good reason. It's simple depth, and it ties you just a little closer to the character. You feel as if you're struggling just to get that little bit higher as you hold the jump button as hard as you can. Equally true for mashing a jump input to scale a wall before you get the smooth climb ability. The jump is imbued with an additional sense of momentum by transferring unused energy into a climb if Ori collides with the wall before the peak of its arc, and if you jump off it, you'll be greeted with a spin. Notice the way her tail actually expands when she does, like with a triple jump in the baked blur. The tail's lag and spread informs a distinct portrayal of her motion. Acceleration exists to simulate the sensation of momentum. A change from walk to jog to run. Too low when you end up conflicting with your intuitive sense of physics. You do have to run before attempting a long jump, but too high and you end up severely troubled in matters of precision. Ori finds a comfortable balance, with a relatively quick acceleration, but directional changes that reset it down to zero for the sake of a more natural feel. Unlike reality, you can quite easily adjust your trajectory in midair, which means you don't have to see where you're landing before you make the jump, or in other terms, which means you can make decisions on the fly. But it isn't enough. What you can't do is adjust just as quickly as you can on the ground, and so to compensate, the double jump allows a quick, elegant reset to all relevant values. It's your course correction, creating some depth in the choice of when to use it and allowing a denser level design to work. The zoomed out camera angle creates the impression of a relatively slow fall that gives Ori a certain graceful lightness to her. Now, much of this sounds open to interpretation, but there's a good reason that critics find themselves unable to articulate their thoughts. Game feel fundamentally relies on the complexities of human psychology, but I'm no expert. Would you like to hear from someone who is? Steve Swink, I quote, "Driving a car, you have a very strong sense of the position of that car, the feel of steering and controlling it, of mastery. This is the ability that every person who's ever learned to drive a car has. The ability to extend precise control over something outside your body. There's a great amount of pleasure in the learning and eventual mastery of such a motion translation. Very abstractly, when you remap your neural pathways, you are feeding your brain, and it rewards you with pleasure. Many people also find this pleasure in video games, where it is both distilled to its essence and free of the constraints and dangers of more physical activities. And that, my friends, is perhaps the reason why Ori feels so good. It's not by the controls feeling tight. It's the game doing the right things. The game does what feels natural, and the platforming has depth and a skill curve. My name is Krifzer, and I hope you all enjoyed."